All right, hey guys, this is Kyle here. We're going to do a review on the new 1 hour premiere of the new Ninja Turtles series. The first episode, 1 hour premiere, just premiered today, brought to you by Nickelodeon. Everyone knows Ninja Turtles are like the most iconic pop icon cartoon franchise like in the history of America. Pretty much everyone knows about the Ninja Turtles. So when I heard that Nickelodeon bought the entire rights of the franchise and we're going to make a CGI animated show, I was not skeptical, but I was very curious as to how would Ninja Turtles plus CGI animation would really work. And honestly, I got to say, it works really well. I think the action scenes and how they fight and so on and so forth with the CGI animation, it works really well. The turtles look great in CGI animation. A lot of shows are really going CGI with animated shows now because technology has just advanced so much as compared to in the 90s. It's kind of like, eh. So I think the CGI animation works really well with the Ninja Turtles. One of the things I love about this new series is the voice cast. I think everyone is great. From Donatello, we've got Rob Paulsen, the guy who did Raphael in the original 1984 Ninja Turtles series is back, and this time lending his voice in the role of Donatello. And a little bit not really apprehensive, but a little bit nervous to see like how would he really work, considering he used to do the voice of Raphael. But seeing him or hearing him and seeing the character Donatello and hearing his voice come out of that character, it really works really well. So I think Rob Paulsen makes a really good Donatello and bringing that character to life, as well as a nice nostalgia act for us old school fans who grew up on the original series. Then you've got Leonardo, whose voice is who Jason Biggs does the voice of. I like it. He does a nice young Leonardo interpretation character. He doesn't seem annoying as some of the other voice actors have lend their voices to the character Leonardo in Ninja Turtles. I don't find it he has to be annoying at all. Very suitable. You know, has that leadership kind of like a young leader kind of like voice. That really suits the character Leonardo. Then you got Raphael, who was always my favorite Ninja Turtle character and still is. The voice of Raphael is being done by Sean Astin. Love this. I love Raphael and this character. This version of Raphael to me kind of takes his character kind of takes a little bit of traits from the 2003 series mixed with the original Raphael. Characteristics. In the original Ninja Turtles, Raphael was kind of witty, but he was just as much of a goofball as the rest of the turtles were, and a bit cheesy at times. The 2003 version series of Ninja Turtles, Raphael's character really took shape, or not took shape, but it was really molded after the way Raphael was portrayed in the live-action movies of Ninja Turtles, where he just pretty much a guy has an anger issue, an anger problem, and walking around every day with a chip on his shoulder. This version of Raphael in the new series here, he's not like a serious anger nutcase like Raphael has been played out to be in the live-action movies in the 2003 series of the Turtles, but he's still a bit comical, and but the way he tells jokes is not goofy. It's very sarcastic and very witty, like the original Raphael in the old series, but it's not over the top. So this version of Raphael characteristics kind of take the personality of both versions of the original and 2003 series of the Turtles and kind of incorporate it to one. So he's not really goofy like the other Raphael, but he's not like an anger issue in a basket case either, like in the 2003 series. He's like right in the middle of both, which balanced it out really well, which I really enjoy. Then you've got Greg Sipes, who does the voice of Michelangelo. Absolutely love it. He fits Michelangelo like a hand in the glove, like a foot in a boot. Probably, I have to say, this guy, hands down, one is going to be my favorite guy to ever do, lend the voice of the character Michelangelo next to the original guy who lent the voice of Michelangelo in the 1980 series. He really brings characters to life. Michelangelo, hilarious in this in the series. I enjoyed his character more than anybody. And everyone did a great job, but Michelangelo to me like really stood out the most in this 1 hour premiere. Really funny and comical. Really loved him and find him enjoyable and a lovable character. And I can really see him being the popular one amongst the younger kids. I can really see him being the popular character there. You also have I think it's Keith Johnson who does the voice of Shredder, who if anyone else doesn't know, he also currently does the voice of Bulkhead in Transformers Prime, one of the main characters, and that another amazing CGI animation show, Transformers Prime, also lends his voice as the voice of Splinter. I mean Shredder, great Shredder. Splinter's not even bad, you know. Splinter's decent. I like the voice of Splinter. Another thing I like about this show is a lot of things they do. They really pay homage to the original 1980 series. I mean, from the opening theme of how when it first comes on, the opening shot that they use in this series is very similar and pretty much identical, but just grafted in CGI animation to the 1980s version of opening. Even the theme song itself, they take some of the lyrics from the original. Only difference is that this version is more of a rap, and they've changed the lyrics, but they've kept the same chorus: Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Heroes in a Half Shell, Turtle Power. They've kept that, which was pretty cool, but nothing beats the original. You guys know, nothing beats the original. But still, a nice added touch. I love the fact that they didn't change anything about the Turtles' origin story. Again, it's very the exact same way how it was in the original Ninja Turtles cartoon. Master Splinter has a human form, fought his enemy, Orokosaki. Very much like, you know, and the 2003 series of Ninja Turtles, the way the turtles, how the turtles became who they were, that stayed true. But Splinter, his background origin story was more. They took homage from the live action movies where Splinter was a pet rat and not a human who turned into a rat, which I didn't particularly care for. So the 2003 series, and I'm not knocking the 2003 series. I like the 2003 series. It was a much darker and darker tone compared to the original Turtles. But, you know, that series was kind of mostly made from, they adapted a lot of elements from the live action movies. As for this one, it really paid homage to the original series in those aspects. The only slight minor change they made was that April O'Neil is a teenager in this version of Ninja Turtles, which I have absolutely no problem with. Donatello has like a little crush on April O'Neil, which I think is a nice, interesting new twist, something that they could do there with the characters as it develops and as the series develops. So yeah, I absolutely have no complaints towards this series whatsoever. I think this Ninja Turtles new series brought to you by Nickelodeon, I think it's going to be a smash hit amongst the kids. I think kids are going to love it. Anybody who's never heard of the Ninja Turtles, I think they're going to love it. As well as I think not only bring in a new audience of generation, a new generation of kids who've never heard or grew up on the Ninja Turtles series, I think this show is also going to do well in bringing in the older fans, such as myself, who grew up watching the 1980 series and who liked the 2003 series, or someone who just doesn't matter what version of Ninja Turtles you grew up watching, the 1980 series, such as myself, or the 2003 series, which I also enjoy, but some people, you know, due to age generations and gaps, some people only grew up with that series. No matter what series you grew up watching, I think you're going to love watching this, especially, again, I plug in the 1980s Turtles. Turtle fans, I think, are really going to like this. So I think the show's going to be a smash hit amongst Nickelodeon. They've definitely been pumping a lot of advertisements. I've seen billboards and various commercials on various channels like Fox News and during when Raw's on air and TNA and SmackDown the other night. So I think it's really going to do a good job for Nickelodeon. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about the new Ninja Turtle cartoon. Do you like it? Don't like it? What do you think about the CGI animation? Do you think it works? No. One other thing I also like about too, I'll mention real quick, is the design of the turtles. The design of the turtles is they took from the comic books. I can't think of the writer's name. You turtle fanboys out there, you guys know what I'm talking about. The design that they have the bandages on their feet and their legs and stuff, and how their shells are kind of like cracked. I think really adds a uniqueness to each turtle, because no, each turtle, their shells all don't look the same. They're all different. They look like battle damaged and stuff. But the artwork is really pays homage to the comic book series, where their upper torso is a little bit slimmer, but their feet and legs are slightly a little bit bigger. So I like that. That's cool. So like they're taking aspects from the comic book and the original 1980 series and kind of combining it together as one, which I think makes a really good blend. So yeah, again, let me know what you guys think. Comment, subscribe, do yourself a favor, and hit that like button. Peace.